Through all this heartbreak and this pain, I can't change. Through the betrayal and the rain, I stay the same. I promise you that I'ma leave how I came. Gotta stop playing, now it's time to be a man. It ain't a thing I can't handle, I'm a champion. It ain't a thing.
Let's go,
oh! Like, the Ridge was definitely a game where we turned the corner. As an offensive line coach, kind of one of the things I focus on is, you know, technique's huge, of course, but you know, I preach to these guys to, our goal is to defeat the will of the defensive guys. You know, not many other positions where your job is to line up against a guy in front of you and push him back 5 yards over and over again. And, you know, best feeling in the world is, third quarter, you're sitting up there, scoreboard says you're a couple touchdowns up, and you've been whooping this guy for, you know, whole three quarters, and you get to look at the guy, and all he wants to do is quit, and you go, I got another quarter to it. Now I'm going to make it work. And that was, Ridge was one of those games where we quickly and violently defeated the will of the defense and ended them.
Touchdown, I felt like it was just setting the tone. We knew the offense had to set the tone that game, get the fire rolling. So scoring that first touchdown, man, I just went all out. It was crazy.
Through all this heartbreak and this pain, I can't change. Through the betrayal and the rain, I stay the same. I promise you that I'ma leave how I came. Gotta stop playing, now it's time to be a man. It ain't a thing I can't handle, I'm a champion. It ain't a thing I can't handle, I'm the chosen one. It ain't a thing I can't handle, I'm a champion. It ain't a thing I can't handle, I'm the chosen one. Yeah, the chosen one.
Point over real quick. Yeah.
Turn the heat up, man. I want them dropping their heads when they walk off the field. They got to come back on the field like, golly, man, these boys here, they on a whole nother level, coach. They foot speed is unbelievable. They physical. I turn right, he meet me. I turn left, he meet me. Coach, it's just too much. Coach, I think we came down here and we was unprepared. Now, guess what now? You can't let up.
To the ceiling, hurting, I need some healing. Gotta do better for my children. I can't give up on my mission. Through all this heartbreak and this pain, I can't change. Through the betrayal and the rain, I stay the same. I promise you that I'ma leave how I came. Gotta stop playing, now it's time to be a man. It ain't nothing I can't handle, I'm a champion. It ain't nothing I can't handle, I'm the chosen one. It ain't nothing. I'm a champion, it ain't nothing I can't handle, I'm the chosen one, yeah, the chosen one, I'm a champion, I'm the chosen one, yeah, I'm a champion. Don't let nobody tell you different, you the greatest. Proud that baby, I'm a baby with a baby. And mama, I've been going back crazy again. I'm going back crazy.
When you think of Dr. Phillips, you think of basketball players, you think of actors, and you definitely think of football. You can go anywhere in the country. When I went to Arizona, what school you go to? DP. Oh, you went to Dr. Phillips in Orlando. Yeah. Yeah, we, you know, haha, Clint Dix. D. Hart. They're going to throw, because they know those players. They know that Dr. Phillips is going to bring players out, just like Miami Northwestern. Mm-hmm. Athletes are going to come out of there no matter what.
Oh,
Get your stuff.
Osceola was going to be a good test for us. Really, I thought that was a game where, you know, if we got it done, depending on how we did from an offensive line perspective, that was the litmus test. Tell us really how good we are. That was a very good defensive line, very good defense. And it was putting in situations where we are undersized. But to, you know, see how well we could do.
So bad, man. Y'all ain't never prayed none this season, but y'all prayed this week. You see how he's trying to get y'all to just come to me when you want something. No. Come to me all the time, and I'll bless you. The cameraman is blessing us. Everybody want to get blessed. Coach Wells want to get blessed. He want to bless you with an opportunity to go and play college football for more years. Y'all got to have faith the size of a mustard seed.
Coming into Osceola, we knew that was going to be a tough game. We had lost to them in the kickoff classic, but we were missing a couple key players, like including Tanner. Tanner was hurt that game. But coming into the playoffs, we knew it was going to be real tough. And then coming to it, us winning in the last 30 seconds, it was just a miracle. It just came down to prayers. But at the end of the day, it was hard work. It was who prepared the most and who wanted it more. That day, we wanted it more. We wanted it more than them. It was a good victory.
Blue and white light. Defense light. Special teams light.
Let's go.
My fist light. Offense light. Defense light. Special teams light. EP light. And the side light. And the side light. And the side light.
We have a coach, Coach Tucker, that is our equipment man. Coach Tucker's been around a long time. My second year of coaching Coach Tucker, we were in the equipment room one day, and Coach Tucker leaned over to me. He's from Georgia, has a little Georgia twang. And he was like, Coach Smith, you never win a championship with the teams you think you're going to win it with. You always win it with the team you don't think you're going to win it with. And at the moment, I didn't really realize what he was saying. But now, you know, I realize exactly what he was saying. You know, I mean, this team love each other. You know, coaches had great cohesion, players, you know, loved one another. It was just a perfect match, the perfect recipe.
Season is Bishon McCray running on the field, our quarterback. He ran on the field during the Osceola game, smiling. He was like, Coach, we got this. We do this every day. So when he did that, he not only calmed myself down, he calmed the coaches and the players down. And then he went out five or six plays later, and scored a touchdown and got us, you know, to the third round, to another great team.
Bickering and complaining. Nobody once told you
that it was going to be easy, Bryce. Not one time. As it was last year, it ain't going to be easy. We got two more to go. All right? I don't know who won, but it don't matter who won. All right? If we do what we do, all right, it don't matter who's on the other side.
What was that face?
I had no idea what it was to be a football wife. We literally, when Rodney got the job 7 years ago, literally we were in like the first stages of dating. Like we probably were like 3 or 4 months in, and I remember not even knowing that it took 10 yards to make a first down, like literally. So like when I'm all in, like when he got the job, I was literally like all in. And so from that day forward, just been kind of like just going all in. And so funny because I remember wanting him to take a day off when he first got the job, and I was like, hey, you want to go away for the weekend? He's like, I got a game. And I'm like, ask somebody to, you know, cover for you. It's just football, but it's really more than just football. I've learned that from, you know, just dating him and just being with him. It's definitely more than football. It is difficult to be a football wife. One, it's just one's in the stands. Like when people are going off about what he's done or what another coach has done, like I want to turn around and be like, don't you be talking about my man or my husband or whatever. But, you know, you have to sit there, you have to take it. And that's like probably one of the hardest things is literally sitting in the stands and hearing somebody criticizing what he's doing or what he is as a, you know, how he is as a person. But I can truly say that a lot of people do have a lot of respect for him at Dr. Phillips. But when I first started, people were like, oh, why is he doing this play? And so it, that was the most difficult part. Another
James, you already know what to do. Have a big play. What you do, baby?
Go deep.
We are in mission mode. Nothing matters. Only thing we focused on is Mickey Mouse. We don't care about the call. We don't care about the flag. We don't care about the crowd. We don't care about their partying. All right? We don't care about their record. Nothing matters. We look through them. We look right through their soul. And at some point, they start to figure out these boys ain't playing. These boys on fire. These boys got somewhere to go. There's nothing that we can do about it. All right? We got three more. Seniors, we got 12 more quarters of football, and then that's it. 12 quarters of football. 12 quarters of all you got. Anybody got any questions?
Yes, sir.
Coaches, you got anything? Anybody got anything? Good? Here we go. Touch your brother. Let's pray it up.
Feels good to be here, but we're not done yet. We got a couple more on the way, but tomorrow we're gonna make it happen. Glory to the King above. Amen. Amen.
The mission was 12, 9, 17, and it's about finishing. We learned a lesson last year on the 10th of December for a reason, and now it's been a year-long process that Coach Ed. We finish it or not, it's on us. Period. End of story. It's not on Wakaiva. It's not on Sarasota. It wasn't on Osceola. It's on us. What a beautiful way to write the end of the story.
I can't give up on my mission. Through all this heartbreak and this pain, I can't change. Through the betrayal and the rain, I stay the same. I promise you that I'ma leave how I came. Gotta stop playing. Chosen one, yeah. I'm a champion. I'm the chosen one, yeah. I'm a champion.
I said, oh, what time is it?
Game time.
Come on, man.
Sandro.
Gotta sound off for
it. 1, 2, 3,
4, 5, 6.
Okay.
We there.
guess what? You got to tune in. Your dial should be on 10 right now. Your dial should be on 10 right now. Opening kickoff sets the tone. We kick to receive, Camping Wold Stadium. We'll be waiting on you. If you fire around the football, first play of the game, Camping Wold Stadium will be setting the locker room up for you.
After the play, hear the whistle, get up, go back to your own hut. All right? If we have any problems with anyone, you guys are the captains. We're going to come to you and ask you to help us. If you have any questions about anything on the field, come to one of us.
To cash in on this opportunity, everybody want to be a beast until it's time to do what beasts do. Everybody want to be a beast. Everybody got a lion. Tattoos of lions. Lions all on their Twitter fake, but everybody got the lion thing, now they tweeting out. Roar. But when it's time to practice, you ain't on beast mode. When it's time to watch film, you ain't on beast mode. You ain't watching your dude. Let me say this and I'm getting out of here. Can I be real with y'all? Most of y'all think that a lion is who he is because of how ferocious he is when he catch that gazelle, when he catch that zebra. Can I be real with y'all? I want y'all to study this when y'all finish to tell me if I'm telling the truth. If a lion see an animal that's wounded, or a real hunter see an animal that's wounded, what do? They do what? They watch him, but they don't do what? They don't kill him. Why don't they kill him? He already hurt. And they beast. A part of being a beast just ain't eating a gazelle. A part of being a beast is the hunts. It's the hunt that they're excited about. They like to see the gazelles run. Then boom, they take off. Do you know that even before the gazelles get there, that the lions start listening to the gazelle? They plan and they all stop and they steal and they wait for the gazelle to come. Do you know that they take a couple lions and say, y'all go that way, and then boom, y'all chase the gazelle. Don't even eat them, just chase them and make them come this way. And when they get this way, they playing games. Cause real lions like to hunt. They love the process just as much as they love the prize. And some of y'all just want to score. You don't like the process. You're not in love with the process. You just like to put the pass on. You love when it's showtime. Everybody in the car, you're like, hey.
Sarasota, Riverview. Again, another physical team. Turned out to be more physical than we thought they were going to be offensively. Defensively, again, Coach Wells and Coach Brightville put together another great scheme. We all rallied behind it. We just knew that it was going to be a great physical game. We knew 100% that we weren't going to be outcoached. It was just a matter of fact, a matter of kids lining up and making plays and doing what they're supposed to do. So going into that week, you know, breaking down the game plan again, you know, being physical, staying in good position, really committing to the weight room, pulling those guys out of the training room, and committing to the weight room. And again, we continued on with the whole theme of, you know, hashtag weight room.
Are a little nervous, but we're going to do well. There's always this sense of excitement and nervous energy that comes with it until we get on that field. I don't know who is more excited or nervous, me or the boys or Coach Wells and the athlete, but I'm excited. We take it one game at a time. As Coach Wells says, we've got 5 games to win, so that's how we have to stay focused, and that's how he keeps the boys focused, is that and grounded, is that this is just another game. We go out and we do our best, but I can't help but say I'm very excited.
All right. Great win. We'd overcome adversity. But again, all right, going into it, we talked about the mission mode. And when somebody go low, guys, we can't do it. And we got caught up. We cannot get caught up in bullcrap. Y'all know everybody is pulling against us. Everybody. We got to stay together. We got to stay strong. We got to stay focused. All right? We'll handle all the business on Monday. All right? Lights up. Lights are open up. Heal up. We in the Final Four again. All right? We got another shot. And state championship. We cannot finish, guys. We cannot finish if we're not focused. We cannot finish, Quinn, if we're not focused. Next week, those penalties don't get us. The state championship, those penalties will get us. The good thing God got favor, all right, over the ones that do things the right way. That's why Quinn put that ball up and took it to the house. All right, listen, everything going to be quick. All right, we don't have time. We're 3 hours away. All right, we're going to get our stuff in the locker room. All right, we're getting on the bus. Parents, you can see them after they come out. All right, after they come out of the locker room and undress. All right, that's a great job, guys. That's a great job.
Coming from a team that just lost states, like, coming in, filling in, like, big shoes. Like, I thought he came in perfect. And, like, he handled it well. Because, like, not everybody come to DP and, like, play quarterback. Not everybody can, like, fit those shoes. So, I get big props to Bashawn coming in and doing his thing and being the first quarterback to do it. I know how I feel because I had it in my hand. It just got taken away. So for him to come in and just finish the job, give props to him.
That's what they want to see. They want to see what you're going to do in the weight room. Come on, man, work. You're going to be a double team all night long, son.
It's going to take more than a few. It's going to take 100% of every coach and every player on this team before Friday and before next Saturday to make a decision. Because when you make that decision that I will be the state champion in 8A this year, everything that you do, everything that you think for the next 9 days, 8 days, revolves around me, Bryce, being a champion. Every decision that I make when I wake up in the morning at 5 o'clock, 5:15, until I go to sleep at night, 10:30, 11 o'clock, revolves around us being state champions. So, it's a thought in a lot of our heads. Now we got to go to the next step and make the decision. Because once we make the decision, it don't matter who they march out there. It don't matter what happened in October. It don't matter what happens in the game. I already made a decision. I made my mind up that I'm going to be the state champion. Therefore, it's nothing what Kyle can do about it.
This year I'm going harder than ever. Learn how they all change like the weather. Now you gone, we forgotten forever. So I'm all by myself, we could've made it together. I'm a god, I ain't signing a deal. They ain't sleep, they just blinded for real. I ain't worried when they claim I'm special. If I ain't number one, then it's wasted potential. Hate to sleep, it's appalling, you simple. Ain't it sweet that I'm balling, a symbol. They ain't a
acquire what I've got in my mentor. I skirt a big whip while you driving a rental. No Tom Cruise, but a dick before you act up. Pretty boy dope sound, so I'm gassed up. Feel bad for the law, I let him passed up. Stay with straight tans at the crib, getting waxed up. I'm growing, you shrinking, I'm floating. You sinking, a king never worries what a peasant be thinking. They waiting on greatness, be cautious when blinking. Got big dreams for the team, so I walk tall. Getting green with the hits like a golf ball. Drink for the team, cause we shine when the mood's right. Toast to the fortune, the fame, and the good life. Haters used to talk, now they stopping. Can't roll with me, so keep walking. Labels at the door, and they knocking. I ain't shining nothing, I'm popping. They can't top this shit I got. I ain't worried about this shit that they talk. I got confidence in my walk. I'm trying to tell them.
Because we knew that, you know, Wakaiba had our number the first game that we played them. But we had confidence because we knew that, again, it's hard to beat a team twice in the same season. So we knew that going into that game that they would have to play their very best to beat us. And then, you know, we would have to play our very best to show up the way we did. So again, throughout the week, the same routine, Monday, bench clean and squat, physical Tuesday, clean circuit on Wednesday, you know, the same routine. We hit that weight room. And going into that Friday, the kids, again, their focus was on to another level. They've made their sacrifices, the coaches made their sacrifices, and it was just really exciting to have an opportunity to go back over to Wakaiba and to play them again on their turf for an opportunity to go back to the state championship.
Please don't doubt me. 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 Yeah, never soft on my ride when it's time. Cut them off if they act out of line. I'll never give trust because I'll change for a price.
Because I actually missed the regular season game because of work. And it was a chance for revenge. You know, we had a disappointing loss and a disappointing performance by the offensive line and some of the other guys. And this was a chance to get back, and right out the gate, we let them know this is a different game. And, you know, 73 yards right up the middle, and we didn't look back. You know, and that was another hard-fought game, but once again, at no point had any doubt in my mind that we would succeed, and we, at no point did we ever really give them a shot to play in that game. That was another one where the offensive line just continued to play together and play strong and oppose our will on the opposing defense.
That's the best QB in the state, just let you know. Man.
Number 11, he'll smoke. Yeah, good, man. Hey, remember that. It's, hey, Stakes, next week.
That boy, too old, man. That boy, too old.
Hey, man. Hey, man. 14-0. First half. They thought we was playing.
The turnover chain came out four times at night, and it was exciting, starting with Tari, our free safety. This is in, I believe it was the second half, and the ball goes over the middle, and we knew when coming out we had to get a stop, because we knew that Wakaba was not going to give up. You know, this was their first time on this stage, but we knew they weren't going to give up, so we knew we had to come out and get a stop. And Tari, the ball came across the middle, and Tari intercepted it. He ran over, and he was just looking because he knew what was getting ready to happen. I unzipped my jacket. Kids anticipated, the fans were anticipating it because now they knew that what we were doing. We ran over to the bench. I stood up on the bench. He came up on the bench with me. He took his helmet off, and I put the chain on him, and the fans just went crazy. the second time it came out, the next two times it came out, Brian had intercepted one for a touchdown, and intercepted another one. Again, both times the kids anticipated, the fans anticipated the unzipping of the jacket, and we both ran over, stood on the bench, and threw it on him. And also, Brian also got the heavyweight belt, because anytime an individual scores on our team, they get the heavyweight belt as well. So he got the turnover chain and he got the heavyweight belt, which was phenomenal for him. And then lastly, Virginia Tech, I call him, he got the last interception of the game. It was just so exciting. That game was just electric. The kids were on fire, as Coach Wells says it, and it was just a good night for us.
I want to talk to you about two kinds of people, and I want to talk to you about leadership. When it comes to leadership, there's two kinds of people. There's thermostats, and there's thermometers. I want you to picture both of those. You picture a thermometer in your mind? You guys know what it looks like? Little sticks, got mercury in it, you put it in your mouth or someplace else to know what temperature your body's at. And then you got a thermostat. What do you do? You go to the thermostat and you mess with the temperature. Both of them have to do about temperature. Both of them are connected to temperature, but they have fundamentally different purposes. One, a thermometer, what's it do? Just tell you the temperature of the room. Tells you the temperature, whatever you put it on. It becomes whatever the room is. And then you got a thermostat. What's a thermostat do? It sets the temperature of the room. Two very different concepts when it comes to leadership, because there are people that are thermometers in their life. Everywhere they go, whatever room they walk in, they just become the temperature of the room, just like everybody else. And then you've got people in life that walk into a room and the temperature changes. You know what I'm talking about, don't you? You guys all know people that when they walk in the room, things change. Just because they walk in the room. And then you guys know people that walk in the room and the temperature just stays the same, no change. I gotta thank this man right here, your coach. He's been a thermostat for a lot of years. Because when I watch him walk around here, whatever room he walks in, the temperature of the room changes. And so here's the decision when it comes to life. Are you gonna be a thermometer or a thermostat? You gonna take the temperature of the room and become like everybody else? Or are you gonna set the temperature of the room? Are you going to take the temperature of your life and just go, well, I want to be like everybody else, so I'll just become like that? Or are you going to set the temperature of your life? And it really is your choice. You know what leaders do? Leaders are thermostats. Leaders are thermostats in every area of their life. And the way it connects with the Bible, with Scripture, is Jesus says this. He says, it is a sin to know the right thing to do and not do it. It is a sin to know what you're supposed to do and choose not to do it. Well, guess who knows what to do and rarely does it? A thermometer. Everybody else doing it. Taking the temperature of the room, becoming just like it. See how the other team's playing and then match their intensity and hope to win, or you can step on the field and set the temperature. Let me tell you what champions do. They step on the field, they set the temperature.
And this year, you know, we finally made it. We finally got there. And I just remember getting on the bus this year, and on the bus ride, the guys were so quiet. Like you could hear a pin drop. And I just knew this year was going to be different. I just knew there was something about this group that was going to take us over the hump.
Y'all boys ready?
Yeah.
Y'all boys ain't ready.
Shoot.
Y'all boys ready?
Yeah.
Y'all boys ain't ready.
Shoot.
Y'all boys ready?
Yeah.
Y'all boys ain't ready.
Let me fire up.
Thank you for being here with me today. Appreciate you for coming. Trust the process.
It felt similar to when I played, you know, but you try to block that out. And then we came out, you know. It was a tough out game, 17-7. Offense, they got the ball moving a lot, but we just couldn't capitalize when we got down on our side of the field. We couldn't score. I think our offense put up 3 points, but you know, looking back.
Everything for a nigga.
Give you all of me. What if I give you all of me? If I give you all of me, would I get all of you? If I told you I'm anointed, could you see the proof? Give my heart and soul for you when I'm inside the booth. Feel my love, feel my pain when I'm inside the booth. Would you switch a change on me if you knew the truth? Knowing I ain't the same person that was introduced. Thank the Lord, cause I don't look like what I've been through. Here's a letter to you. I'm back again. Jesus on that cross, I had to rise again. Time to get my blessings, time to get my blessings. I had to live my life, I had to learn my lessons. I had to keep that smile, but deep inside I'm stressing. Just trying to keep my spirits from that deep depression.
Sandro, this is it, baby. Hashtag weight room, let's go. Let's get it, baby. Ain't no training room tonight, baby. We in the weight room all night. We in the weight room all night. Make them work, Bryce. Make them work, Bryce, come on. Good work. Good job. Get that inside gap, man. Alright? Get that inside gap. Good work. Stick it there, man. Let's go. Texas. Oh, I like the feet, Bryce. I like the footwork, baby.
Queen, she know I love her till it's life or death. Living on the edge, plotting on the plans. Nothing without God, nothing without my fans. Sorry for my absence, hope y'all understand. No more we the best, but Cali still my mans. Critics want the beef, but I'm not feeding in. My loyalty don't stop if we don't speak again. I could cry tears right now. You don't know how I feel right now. All that meditation that I did, all that beasting in the gym, all this energy inside I got to give. Back and I'm better than y'all. Ready whenever the call. They expecting me to fold. Friends turn into your foes. Kept focused on the goals. Mind, body, and the soul. New me, it's a new day. That's another story untold. God, nigga. Yeah.
to the state championship game. Now, that one was a fun one because we had the mindset all year after the loss from last season of what we needed to do to get there. And now we're there. So it was, what do we need to do to win? We had two drives going, and I'll give it to them. It was a very good defense, and it was ended up being a defensive game. Two drives got us down the red zone, and we were unfortunately unable to capitalize on those. And we went into halftime 10-0. And I know everybody in the back of everybody's mind, we're sitting there going, this is not where we want to be. 10-0 was the halftime score the previous state championship game, and you know, we ended up losing that game. And we had missed opportunities on the field going into that half, and it should have been a rout. And here we are, 10-0. What do?
First state championship, it means a lot. These kids, I don't think they know exactly what they did. They're just living right now in the moment. It'll take a couple years for it to hit. You know how special this group was and how resilient, you know, this group was. And they did a good job doing what we talked about, which is finishing.